Phoenix, Arizona, players and fans alike are enjoying the luxury of the closed roof and air conditioning. It's the second game of this ALCS between the Houston Astros and the New York Yankees.
And now, your 2021
Game 2 of this year's ALCS starts now.
Yankees.
Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve. Hot shot to third and handled for the first down. So one out and nobody aboard. And that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. Here it comes on 1-1. Hit in the air down the left field line. Frazier is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now. Next to him, Michael Brantley. That's a foul ball off to the left, and it moves to 1-2.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Count even at 2-2. This pitch is popped up. Voit waits on it. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. A 1-1. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down. And stepping in, Aaron Judge. One out, nobody on. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And another foul ball.
That's a great sinker right there. These batters are going to have to bear down, because if he's got that good pitch working, it's going to be a long game. They might have to sit off speed.
So he got him swinging. Aaron Judge becomes the second out of the bottom of the first. The 1-2.
It's going to be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Trying to strike out the side. Here it is. High in the air out to center field. Strong able to track it down for the third out. New inning set to get underway. And next will be the imposing power bat, Carlos Correa. 1-1. Sent in the air out to straightaway center. After it is Hicks. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Striding forward now is the DH, Yordan Alvarez. Sinker misses, ball four. So next to hit is Yuli Gurriel. Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. Hits this one hard the other way. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. Into the box now, Kyle Tucker. And he's keeping it down here, and that's a cold strike two. Fouled away. marking for the punch out and the offering. And this one's in the dirt. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here. Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin the win if he starts looking for it in there.
So he sets him down swinging. Kyle Tucker is sent packing for out number two in the inning. And that one yanked just foul. Alvarez over at second. Gurriel at first, two out in the inning. Hit back toward the mound. And that's through into center field. Base hit. And they'll put the brakes on that runner at third, and that means the bases are loaded now with two away. Into the box, Jason Castro. And he strikes him out. So a missed opportunity at the plate as he strands three runners and the side is retired. Riding forward now, the Yankee cleanup hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. His prior history in this matchup, he's 1-for-2. He's falling behind now, 3-1.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around a leadoff walk.
3-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. And now here is Luke Voit,
the first baseman.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
So he sets him down swinging. Luke Voit goes down for the second out in the bottom half. Yankee shortstop behind in the count 1-2.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruise.
Well, the play's been made, and with it comes the end of the inning. Top of the order now, and striding in the speedy second baseman, Jose Altuve. Here comes the 1-2. Swing and a liner, but this will land in foul territory. Still 1-2.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Made a miss on the off-speed pitch that time. Jose Altuve goes down for the first out here in inning number 3. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Into the windup and the pitch. Third inning, no score to this point. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
And that gets through for a one-out base hit. Standing in now, Michael Brantley fouled away. Bregman, runner at first with one gone in the inning. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball.
I really like watching Righty throw that cutter in on Lefty's hands like that. This one was down too, and if he hits it, there's a pretty good chance he's going to pound it into the ground. Maybe even give himself a shin burger.
And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full. 3-2.
Gotta believe that runner from first is gonna be in motion, especially in this situation. As an offensive player, just hit something hard because those defenders are gonna be moving.
Again, he sends it out of play. comes the payoff pitch. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Up next to the Astros.
So now here is Carlos Correa looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. Hard sinker misses 2-2.
Hey, expect a challenge right here. Does not want to run the count full.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Judge is on the move. He gets there, and that's the second out. Two on, two out, and that'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. All even now, 2-2. Swing and a miss and a sinker. The strikeout retires the side. Inning is over. Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring up the outfielder Clint Frazier. Late that time for a strike. Swung on in the dirt, strike three. And he makes the throw to first. Frazier is retired, and there's one away. Next for New York, Gio Urshela. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. And a foul popped behind the plate. Castro has a play, and that's the second out of the inning. So now into the box is Gary Sanchez. This guy's still looking at a zero in the hit column. The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Not a spot you expect a curveball. He's lucky he missed because that's the kind of pitch that gets hit out of the ballpark.
Too much dip on the sinker. Laid off for a ball. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now. 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a...
We'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. All set for the start of the inning, and digging into bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
Hit on the ground out to short. Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth. Digging in will be Kyle Tucker, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there.
And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. So now to the plate, Miles Straw, a base hit in his first trip. 1-1 is laid off for ball two. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2. Three and two now. Jason Castro would be next. A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. A shot to first base and caught there to end the inning. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, DJ LeMahieu, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
Next up is Aaron Judge. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. And this is low, ball two. 2-1. never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Swing and a miss on the breaking pitch. Two away. Into the box. Aaron Hicks flew out in his only at bat so far.
Aaron.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Ah gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone. 1-2. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down at first and no swing. It's ball two. 2-2. Chopped loopily up the first base line. Fouled off. 2-2 one more time. He is swung on and missed. He got him. Striding in for Houston, Jason Castro. He'll start off the fifth in this one. 1-1. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Now another 2-2. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
What a great battle to start this inning. What a great job by the leadoff hitter. He knows that this pitcher's starting to get up there in pitches.
And hold on now, that's a fair ball down the left field line. Should be at least a double. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out. Blake now, Jose Altuve. And there's one away. Man at second with one down, and that'll bring up Alex Bregman. The 1-1 home. Swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. And no one can get there. He'll try it again. Now look out. As this one sends him sprawling. It's ball two now.
Yeah, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Down the first baseline. He's got it. And he'll take this one to the bag for the out. But meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base. Next to hit is Michael Brantley. It was a walk in his last trip. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But a foul ball. 1-2 to count now. Here's the 1-2. And a sinker called strike three as he's rung up and the side is retired. Set now for the bottom of the fifth. And digging in is the big-time power threat, Giancarlo Stanton. The 1-1 home.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Late making contact on that swing, and we'll do it again on 1-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And he punches out another one. Make it 9 for the ball game. And now, Luke Voit struck out in his first at-bat. And the perfect game will go by the wayside here as this pitch misses for ball four. At the plate now is Gleyber Torres. Bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
And he is safe at second base as the decision to move up pays off, and that'll likely be scored a wild pitch. Here's the 2-2.
Helpful.
Clint Frazier will be next. Looking for his 10th strikeout. Here's the pitch. And this pitch misses here as well. Back-to-back walks now, but at least that'll put the force back in order here. The 1-1 home. Makes him swing and miss on a ball out of the zone for strike two.
Great pitch in that situation. He makes contact on that one. More than likely, he's hitting into a double play.
Hit out towards second. And that's through into right field for the base hit. And they will hold that runner over third as he'll move up only 90 feet. But the bases are loaded with one away. Stepping in now, Gio Urshela. And he fouls this one off. And he struck him out. The 10th victim set down on strikeouts. So our situation has the bases loaded. Two men out. And the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher, Gary Sanchez. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ballgame, and this one ends the inning. To swing the bat will be Carlos Correa. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. And it's fouled away. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Soft grounder left side. Barehanded pickup. It's in time. One away for the Astros here in the sixth, and that'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. 1-1. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. And there's out number two. Now to the plate, Yuli Gurriel grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground.
Oh, hang on now. This ball is crushed into left field, and this one ain't coming back. This ball is gone. So now to the plate, Kyle Tucker. This one is smashed down the right field line. That's going to stay fair, and it's going to be back-to-back home runs. At the plate, Miles Straw. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Ball three. 3-2 now.
And this is where he's especially dangerous, because if you walk him, he can steal the ball.
Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
He's just rolling right now, and even dozen strikeouts for another ball game. Aaron. So stepping in is Aaron Judge. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0 for 2 at this point. And that gets through for a one-out base hit. And this will find the wall deep in the corner. And he'll pull into second with one away. To the plate now, Aaron Hicks. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. Judge, a runner at second with one away. Ball three, not close with the sinker that time.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Fouled away. This is foul right side. As he just continues to mow down these hitters. 13 strikeouts now. And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. Runner in scoring position with two gone. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And with just 5 2/3 innings under his belt, he's about to hit the century mark in his pitch count now.
Yeah, Matty, being in the way baseball is played these days, it's about 6 innings for 100 heaves, and you're pretty much looking for that bullpen. And D-Wall, right now, this guy's pretty vulnerable right now.
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. Garen O'Day is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 55. Garen.
Seventh inning ready to roll. And that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Jason Castro. Misses to the Houston catcher. It's 2-1 now. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Don't quite know where that one missed, but it's not for me to decide. 3-2.
When you're playing close games like runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Up to the plate next will be Jose Altuve. No hits in 3 tries so far. He struck out once. The 1-2. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing. And that'll bring up the former first-rounder Alex Bregman. Will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first 2 guys going down on strikes to start the inning. A ball and 2 strikes now. 2 runs, 6 hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. And just a masterful drop of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. Leading off the inning, it'll be Luke Voit as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Now the 1-1 pitch.
2 balls, 1 strike.
Two and two. Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, Matt. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
And there's one down now. Now at the plate, Gleyber Torres. It was a walk in his last trip. Sinker gets too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Swung on and missed. 3-2. And he loses him on a breaking ball. Next, it'll be Clint Frazier. He steps in off a base hit in his last at bat. He's set and the 2-1 pitch. Struck him out and make it 14 punch-outs now in the game. Now at the plate here is Gio Urshela. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. The 2-1 on its way. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball, 2-2.
Boy, he's been great in this one. He's only one strike away from putting another zero on the scoreboard.
Hit hard back up the middle. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit. In now, Gary Sanchez. Oh, right back to him on the mound. Throw on to first, and the Yankee threat goes by the boards as the inning is over. Justin Wilson has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Leading off the inning, it'll be Michael Brantley trying to pad their lead here before the bottom of the inning. A little behind on that swing, and now they'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. And he lays off the pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. So here's the Astros cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. A shot to left field and deep. Look at this. Gone. Into the box now, Yordan Alvarez. And that's into the corner of foul ball and right. Set. Here's the 2-2. Yuli Gurriel will be next. The 3-2 pitch is a called third strike right on the inside corner. So two gone now in the Houston eighth. And digging into bat next, the Cuban import Yuli Gurriel.
To show you how strong this guy is, he hit that last off-speed pitch over 400 feet, so the pitcher wasn't supplying most of the power there. This is a really strong hitter.
Popped up. Voit is there for it. And he's got it for the final out of the frame. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up DJ LeMahieu. Lifted into the air to shallow center. Here's the center fielder. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Here's big Aaron Judge. He doubled his last time through. No runs, three hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Good spot for that pitch as it's chopped foul. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Going for strikeout number 15.
You know, you don't always have to straight challenge a guy on the 3-2 count. With the three-run lead, no one on base, this is the perfect situation to do it. No reason to nibble and possibly set up a big inning.
And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. So the next to bat will be Aaron Hicks. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. slow roller left side. Bregman gloves it. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Zach Britton enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Kyle Tucker. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth. Next up for the Strohs, Miles Straw. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. The 1-1. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Hicks is after it. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Now Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. And he struck him out. So a good pitch there. And now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at bat if they want to get back in this thing. Ryan Pressly comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Number 55.
For the plate now is the designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton.
Hey, not impossible, but highly improbable. Even when you're at home to score 3 runs off a closer like this guy, they've got the work cut out for him.
Fouled off. And fouls this one off.
Big fastball is definitely this guy's MO coming out of the bullpen.
2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. Could this be the start? It's a long way back, but the leadoff man is on base to start their final set of at-bats. Now the 1-1 pitch. Looked at the ball number 2.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
Brantley is there, one away. Next up would be Gleyber Torres.
The batter, left shortstop.
Stanton, base runner at first with one out.
Torres.
And it's fouled away. Pulled pretty badly there as he reaches to poke this one foul.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
And this is taken for a ball high and tight, 2-2. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are 2 down. And now in the box, Clint Frazier comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. 2 out here in the ninth. The 2-1 is a fastball that misses.
Well, this is a big pitch right here. 2 outs in the ninth. The last thing you want to do is walk a guy and bring the tying run to the plate.
And this is swung on and missed. So now they find themselves down to their final strike tonight. Last chance for the Yankees. And that misses ball 4. So it's first and second now with 2 out. That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
There isn't a hitter alive that doesn't love hitting at fastball counts like 3-1. It's usually a pretty fruitful count in terms of getting a pitch to drive.
Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Fouled away. One strike from a shutout. Here it comes. Fouled off. Payoff pitch one more time. And this ball swung on and hit to center field. And this should do it. He'll put this one away for the final out, and the Astros will take a 2-0 lead back home for game three as this one is over.
Man, we were treated to a nice pitcher's duel in this one. Both starters throwing strikes, they worked deep, and both were in command of the game. It really came down to a few key at-bats. This was a fun game to watch.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. And tonight's ends as a 3-0 shutout win. The Houston Astros get the win to take a 2-0 series lead. Framber Valdez is the winning pitcher of record. Corey Kluber pitched well, allowing only 2 earned, but ends up taking the loss. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 3 runs on 7 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. For the Yankees, no runs, no errors. They left 8 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 33 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.